during the last year when the Maharashtra and other bans came, Kerala, the biggest hits on the internet, all the videos that went viral in Kerala were of BJP leaders eating beef. Because everybody eats beef there. And it was wonderful. I was watching the BJP leaders explain. One said, that video is 4 years old, I've given it up. Another said, no, no, it is roast onion and potato. But they did not take any legal action against the filmmakers because it was beef. At the Bombay Baikulla Zoo, tigers and lions were being fed chicken. Okay? Do you know how many chicken you have to kill to feed a lion? And it's not red meat. You are committing genocide in the chicken world to feed one zoo. 42% by definition. Your census tells you. 42% are people with absolutely no problem with beef. That, do we have this context in our heads when we write about this? Do we, you know, it's not as if people become defensive and think, oh, this is this government, it's basically trying to harm Muslims. This is an attack on a minority. I'm saying it's an attack on more than 50% of the population, if you ask me. How do, it may be different how they perceive it, but this is the reality. The second thing about the beef issue. There was a book banned in the UPA's time, banned in the Vajpayee time and not restored in the UPA's time, by Professor D.N. Jha, a historian of Delhi University, called The Holy Cow, where he explains to you that beef consumption was a very common and widespread practice in ancient India, which runs into trouble when it in fact is so widespread that it starts hurting the existing cattle herd and cattle stock in a society where large numbers of people were essentially pastoral nomads. It came to a point where eating your cow was eating your currency. So there were injunctions on it. By the way, all the injunctions made on it made great exceptions for the ruling classes. They all had this. Now, it was because of an economic crisis, because of the loss of the cattle herds, the shrinking of the herds, that this whole situation came up. Now, I want to tell you something about today's crisis, which might surprise you. The 2007 and 2012 census livestock both showed a declining trend in livestock wealth in the country, and both showed a particularly steep decline in Indian breeds of cattle. Why do I say livestock? Because other than cattle, the sharpest decline, not beyond, in much more than cattle, the sharpest decline in livestock is in small animals. It's in small animals like pigs, goats. Who are the people who keep pigs and goats? Adivasis, Dalits. Poor people keep these animals. And then scrub cattle, which is more for dung than for milk. Go to any forest, that Adivasi will keep that kind of cow. Okay? So you have, in the 2012 census shows you an overall drop in the livestock wealth of the country, particularly small animals. It even shows you a drop in cattle wealth, and within the drop in cattle wealth, Desi breeds, Indian breeds, are the sharpest drop. because for 25, 30 years, we have been promoting Jersey cow, Swiss breed, Swiss brown, Holstein, you know, and a lot of progressive people, politically progressive people, have no idea and no understanding of the kind of damage that has been done through that hybriding of exotic breeds from. See, the Jersey cow, the Holstein, the Swiss breed, they are wonderful cows for European climates. It took over a million years, they evolved this thick, hard skin for the European winters. When I watch a poor bloody Jersey or Holstein in Yavatmal in 47 degrees heat, shivering in the heat, do you know what one of the great cattle breeders of Kerala told me? As long as I had these Swiss Holsteins and Browns and Jerseys in my, he said, the veterinarian lived in my house. I spent 400, his name is Chandran Master of Thrissur. He said, the veterinarian lived in my house. He says, every day they spent 300 rupees, 400 rupees on each of these animals. You have to feed the damn thing, it eats like an elephant. Then he switched over to Desi cows. He's a retired teacher of English. Now he showed me, he said, the veterinarian and the veterinary department bring their students here to look at how I'm breeding my cows. My cows are healthy. Because they were not made for that climate. They are very susceptible to local disease. They don't have the immunity against those bugs and germs. So this is one. Anyway, but here's the problem. BJP government has introduced unbelievable issues on cow slaughter and especially cattle for slaughter. I'm telling you that already, even in the UPA's time, there has been a steep decline. Because of this exotic breeds fascination. You also have to know one more thing. A socialist writer thinks in class. Okay? Exotic breeds work very well for some farmers. Those big farmers who are taking breeding cattle for market, who are taking milk to market, for them some of these big breeds will work very well. They can keep them in air-conditioned places, they can keep them in cool sheds. The poor farmer, the poor peasant, he keeps that cow for consumption. He keeps the cow for milk in the household. For him, the exotic breed, you see, when Manmohan Singh, unfortunately it was all my fault, when I wrote about Vidarbha, Manmohan Singh landed up in Vidarbha and distributed hundreds of buffaloes and cows. I said the people, I told him, sir, the people you are distributing these cows to, they cannot afford to raise them. They are not cattle breeders. They have no, it costs 250 rupees a day to look after the Jersey cow. 500, and they have a lovely word in India because they are hybrid. They're called Adha Jersey. Half cow, half Jersey. Then I told him that you are going to have serious problems because your cows will bankrupt the owner. All 30 out of 36 cows in one village, 30 were dead in 6 months. Okay, soft loans, 25%. And that poor fellow is paying 20 on that 25%, he's repaying his loan. Some were given free. Then I found one old lady, Kamla Bai Gude, going around with a buffalo. I asked her, what are you doing? She's saying, I'm trying to give it away. Nobody will buy it. I'm asking people to take it free. She gave it off to one person free. After a week, he came back. Again, I was at her house. He returned the buffalo and said, you keep this. This is not for me. Then she said, she told me, ye bais nahi hai saab, ye bhoot hai. She said, this is not a buffalo, it's an evil spirit. It is eating more than my entire family does. How will I refeed this damn buffalo? So the big exotic breeds are for very rich farmers and farmers who are producing milk for the market. The millions of small cows we have, those are for household consumption. The dung is used, the urine is used, the milk is just sufficient for a small family. That's why I'm saying, think when you think of agriculture and peasants and farmers, the socialist writer has class factored into it. Okay? That is, now why am I saying it will decline very sharply? Let me tell you what happened when the Maharashtra government extended the beef ban in 2015 from just 15-16, from the old beef ban that existed, old cow slaughter ban, extended it to bulls, progeny, all sorts of stuff. The first 2 weeks, it was actually tragically comic. At the Bombay Baikulla Zoo, tigers and lions were being fed chicken. Okay? Do you know how many chicken you have to kill to feed a lion? And it's not red meat. You are committing genocide in the chicken world to feed one zoo. Okay? That is the extent of... Now everybody, the media came down and did stories. BBC sent a crew just for that. Okay, to do the story, I mean, BBC had a crew there to do a story on the lions and tigers eating chicken. Then somehow they blacked that, I mean, they covered it up and were giving them carcasses of old dead cows and stuff. I have no idea how the problem was resolved or if it is resolved at all, but it's gone out of the media. Now, what, of course, there is the ideological aim of hurting another community, the ideological aim of imposing an order, a social order. The cow is a very important part of your caste system. And the socialist writer will notice this and understand this. It is linked to status in the caste hierarchy. Okay? Don't ever forget that. It is so important, by the way, to the status of the Brahmin. That the Brahmanical need to assert the supremacy of the cow, not the tiger, as the national animal. Okay? This is extremely important. So you build myths and hierarchies around cow because essentially you are connecting it to the status in society itself of your caste group or your community group. But here is what happened. They wanted to hurt the Muslim community. So they passed this order. Muslims are mainly in the butcher, most people in the butcher communities are Muslims. So they hurt Muslims. And they destroyed the Marathas. They destroyed the OBCs. They devastated, finished the Dalits. How did that happen? Cattle markets, usually the dalal, the agents at the cattle markets, the organizers of the cattle markets, you all know what cattle markets are. Every 10 villages will have one cattle market. Once a week you can go there and see the trade in cattle. Mostly the organizers and dalals of the cattle markets are OBCs in Maharashtra. They're OBCs. Okay? Now, cattle market prices collapsed. Today, your front page of New Indian Express is saying Salem collapsed 80%. Do you know when if you are an IAS officer, probationer, when you are trained at Mussoorie Academy, one of the lessons they give you when you go on probation is, if cattle market prices fall by 30%, you have a crisis. If you see distress sale of cattle in your district, you have a crisis. And one of the ways of measuring the distress sale is if cattle prices fall by 30%. In Maharashtra, they fell by 60% last year. Now, New Indian Express is saying this morning at the market they looked at, it had fallen 80%. Does anyone have the New Indian Express? You can just see the item just now. 80% means that lots of livelihoods dependent on the cattle market are completely devastated. The next step is farmers. Farmers keep cattle. Now the farmer can neither sell nor buy the cattle. He keeps the cattle, milch animal, the milk cow, is productive for a certain number of years. At the end of that time, you sell it off. You sell it to the abattoir, you sell it to the slaughterhouse, you sell it on the market. Now you can't do that. Because you take your cow and you go out, three Bajrang Dal people will come and assault you and lynch you, and every day two, three people are being murdered in the country, and that's only what's being reported. Every day two or three people are being butchered and, you know, I mean they are being butchered, they are being lynched every day. Then in Maharashtra, the next day, so we were meeting farmers who told us, we met farmers who told us, look, the man has six cows. During the drought, he was saying, I can't get water and food for my family. How will I feed the cow? I said, why don't you sell it? He said, how will I sell it? The bloody market rate is down 60-65%. And if I take my cows out, these fellows are going to attack me. In Uttarakhand, people are taking their old cows, and even in other areas, and leaving them on the edge of the forest so that the leopards get them. Okay? They're leaving them at the edge of the forest so that the leopards get them, because they can't take them and get them slaughtered. Now you've made it. Then the next stage, Dalits, they were the worst affected by this. Now the cow slaughter ban comes, the bullocks, buffaloes, everything slaughter ban falls. What happens to the hides? There is one industry in Maharashtra which had a global brand before Make in India, before Mr. Modi was heard of, and it was called the Kolhapur Chappal. All of you have seen the Kolhapuri Chappal. The Kolhapuri Chappal, who are the people in the Kolhapuri Chappal? Dalits. Those who make the chappals, those who tan the hides, those who flay the hides, those who process the leather, those who make the chappal are all Dalits. They're finished. The Kolhapuri Chappal industry is in the doldrums. It was already suffering with the UPA's policies towards local manufacture. Now it is. They have come and delivered the coup de grace to the thing. Now here is the picture. One, there is a steep decline from census to census of livestock, particularly Deshi breed. Two, you have policy measures that have destroyed the cattle markets, made it impossible to have a sale and trade. Now some of the capitalist newspapers and media are beginning to make small noises, because they're looking at it in terms of commerce, they're looking at it in terms of trade. Our export of hides and leather is worth $6 billion a year. Our export of meat, incidentally, in Modi's first year, beef exports reached their highest ever. Now all that will go, and so the capitalist media are concerned about the commerce and trade problems that come up. You will be concerned about the devastation to livelihoods, to human beings. And now when the Dalits have no hides, you know what happened next? They tried getting hides from Krompet. They tried accessing and sourcing hides in Kolhapur from Tamil Nadu, because Tamil Nadu processes and produces a lot of hides. When they did that, the vans were attacked and burned by Bajrang Dal and VHP in Karnataka-Maharashtra border. They were destroyed there, the vans. So now even that source has become impossible. It's extremely difficult to be seen with the cow. when all this has happened, buying and selling of cows has become next to impossible. Now, if I'm a cattle breeder, I'm going to have problems. If you're a farmer, you're going to think, why should I buy a new thing? I can't get rid of it when it's not productive. If you're a dalal at the market, you are thinking of looking for other employment. The cattleman, therefore, you're going to see a further steep acceleration of the decline of India's cattle wealth. I am actually telling you that the cow slaughter ban is anti-cow. That is the important thing. So, do you see how much of a little... See, when we look at the cow slaughter ban in the media, we are looking at BJP versus Muslims and hurting trade. When you look at it as a socialist writer, when you look at it as a progressive writer, through the lives of people, you're seeing a whole universe that is affected. A mini universe in which millions of people are devastated and affected by what has happened in this thing. I have to tell you that there was some fun also during the last year when the Maharashtra and other bans came. Kerala, the biggest hits on the internet, all the videos that went viral in Kerala were of BJP leaders eating beef. Because everybody eats beef there. And it was wonderful. I was watching the BJP leaders explain. One said, that video is 4 years old, I've given it up. Another said, no, no, it is roast onion and potato. But they did not take any legal action against the filmmakers because it was beef.